Hey everyone, my name is Ryan Wold, and I'm a Senior Support Escalation Engineer on the Surface Hub Support Team at Microsoft. In this video, I'll be introducing the new Teams Rooms on Surface Hub client that recently began rolling out worldwide. This new client is based on the desktop Electron app and has some really great new features. Previously, the Teams app was installed and updated through the store. Now, this new client is initially installed through Windows Update, and all subsequent updates are installed by the Teams client itself in the background. Let's dive into some of the new features, which are all documented in our administrator guide. I'll head over to the Surface Hub 2S on the left, then Deploy, and then Microsoft Teams Rooms on Surface Hub. Under the What's New section, we can see when you join a meeting, the Teams app will now display edge to edge, so people are in the foreground. Chat bubbles, reactions, app sharing, give and take control, as well as audio, PowerPoint Live support, Together mode, and Large Gallery View are all now available. The new client can run side-by-side with other apps, or minimized, which maximizes screen real estate. There's also new admin options to configure coordinated meetings within the app and proximity join, which I'll demonstrate in a bit. In addition, there are new quality of service settings, which are different than what the previous Teams client used. And lastly, Teams will now be the default communication app over Skype for Business. Now let's take a look at the new Microsoft Teams Rooms on Surface Hub. To launch the app, I'll click Call on the welcome screen. As you can see, the interface has been updated. But before joining a meeting, I'll show you the new admin settings available. I'll click the three dots at the top right of the screen, then Settings. Here, you'll enter the admin credentials, which are the same ones used to sign into Settings. On the Accounts page, you'll see your device account listed. If you click Manage, it will open the regular device account settings on the Hub. On the Devices menu, there are a few new options, including the ability to turn off automatically adjusting mic sensitivity. Heading over to the Coordinated Meetings page, we now have the ability to locally configure this, just like an MTR device, including the ability to add the trusted device accounts you want to set up coordinated meetings with. Exiting the admin settings, I'll press Meet Now to show you some of the cool new features available within Teams Meetings. There are new share options, including the ability to share the computer audio through Teams. With this, audio presented during a meeting will be passed through the Teams call, which is great for video playback. You can also add a background, and this share menu is where you would open the whiteboard, as well as use different presenter modes. Under the More Actions menu, we have some new options here as well. First, I'll open Device Settings. Here, you can select which speaker, microphone, and camera to use. For Meeting Options, we now have the ability to adjust the lobby behavior, who can present, as well as other various settings. There's also a Breakout Rooms button, where you can create breakout rooms. And a reaction button, so you can silently express yourself during a meeting. Pressing Show Participants brings up another menu where you can download the attendance list. This saves a CSV file with everyone who joined the call in the Downloads folder on the Surface Hub. We also have the ability to lock the meeting here. One of my favorite Teams features on the Surface Hub is Teams Coordinated Meetings. I'll quickly show you what this experience looks like. With this, you can configure a Microsoft Teams Room device, as shown here, to coordinate the meeting experience with another device, in this case, a Surface Hub. With coordinated meetings, administrators can choose which cameras, speakers, and microphones are used, which will give meeting participants the best possible experience depending on the room and available equipment. Once coordinated meetings are configured, you simply join the meeting from one device, and all others will open the same call automatically. On the MTR, you then have meeting controls at your fingertips, so raising your hand or adjusting audio is a seamless experience. The last new feature I'll go over is Proximity Join. This allows users to take scheduled Teams calls on a nearby Surface Hub using their laptop or phone. You can also seamlessly transition an in-progress meeting to a device. I'll demonstrate this by clicking Meet Now in the Teams desktop client, and then Start Meeting. you'll see Room Audio as an option, and Search for a Room. Clicking this searches for nearby Surface Hubs using Bluetooth. I'll select Hub 20, and then Join Now. This will call the Surface Hub, where you can accept it. This can also be configured to automatically join the call, so this prompt doesn't appear. So that's the overview of the new Teams Rooms on Surface Hub. Thanks so much for watching.